Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I am going to share with you how to make a garlic with crochet. So to make this garlic, I have used single crochet stitches and total 15 round with single crochet stitches to get this size. You can use this garlic in any of your home decoration or kitchen decoration. So let's see what all I have used to make this garlic. I'm going to use this white color thin cotton thread. I'm going to make two layer of this thread to give the thickness, and for this tip and this bottom part I have this green and brown embroidery thread, so I'm going to use this two color. And for this cotton thread I'm going to use crochet hook of size 2.0 mm. We'll also need one needle, stitch marker, one scissor and some fiber filling to stuff. So before we start to make this garlic, I would request you, if you are watching my channel first time, please subscribe to my channel so you get to know my more creation and ideas with crochet. So let's see how we are going to make this. So I've taken two layers of this thin cotton thread. If you are using different thread, just take one layer. Now first round we are going to make a magic ring. Once you have a ring, now in this ring we are going to make 6 single crochet stitches. 1, 2, 3. So like this you have to make total 6 single crochets. After 6 single crochet stitches, just pull this loose end to close this ring. So round 1 is done. Here we are not going to make a slip stitch, we are going to work continuously. So in round number 2 we are going to make 2 single crochet stitches in each stitch from the previous round. So take your hook in top of very first stitch from the previous round and make 2 single crochets. So one more in same stitch. Put the marker in your first stitch. So 2 single crochets. Now in next stitch make 2 single crochets. So like this make 2 single crochet in remaining stitches. So at the end of round number 2 you will have 12 stitches. So round number 2 is done with 12 stitches. Now in round number 3, in top of very first stitch from the previous round, make 1 single crochet. Then top of next stitch, make 2 single crochets. Put the marker in your first stitch. Now repeat this stitches. In next stitch make 1 single crochet, then in next stitch make 2 single crochet, and like this repeat till your last stitch. So at the end of round number 3 you will have 18 single crochet stitches. So 18 stitches. Now in round number 4 make next 2 stitches from the previous round, make 1 single crochet. put the marker in your first stitch. Then in third stitch make 2 single crochets. So like this, repeat these stitches. In next 2 stitches make 1 single crochet. Then in next stitch make 2 single crochet and repeat till your last stitch. So at the end of round number 4 you will have 24 stitches. Now in round number 5, in next 3 stitches from the previous round make 1 single crochet. Put the marker in your first stitch. Then in next stitch make 2 single crochets. So like this you have to repeat these stitches. In next 3 stitches make 1 single crochet. Then next stitch make 2 single crochet and repeat till your last stitch. So at the end of round number 5 you will have 30 stitches. So round number 5 is done. Now from round number 6 to 9 we are going to make 1 single crochets in top of each stitch from the previous round. So at the end of round number 9 you will have 30 stitches. Put the marker in your first stitch. One single crochet. Then in next stitch, one single crochet. So like this, complete round number 6, 7, 8 and 9 with 1 single crochet. So round number 9 is done and we have 30 stitches. Now from round number 10, we are going to decrease the single crochet stitches. So in next 3 stitches make 1 single crochet. Put the marker in your first stitch. So after 3 single crochet we are going to decrease 1 single crochet here. So to do the decrease, take the front loop of next single crochet. This. Now take the front loop of next single crochet. So you will have 3 loop in your hook. Now grab this thread and pull through first 2 loop. Now grab the thread and pull through next 2 loop. So like this we have decreased 1 single crochet. Now again in next 3 stitches make 1 single crochet. Then make 1 decrease. So like this you have to repeat these stitches. In next 3 stitches make 1 single crochet, then 1 decrease and repeat these stitches till your last stitch. So at the end of round number 10 you will have 24 stitches. Now in round number 11, in next 2 stitches make 1 single crochet. After 2 single crochets, next 2 stitches make 1 decrease. Then next 2 stitches make 1 single crochet. Then 1 decrease. So like this, you have to repeat this stitches. In next two stitch, make one single crochet, then one decrease, then two single crochets, then one decrease. Repeat till your last stitch. So at the end of round number 11, you will have 18 stitches. Now in round number 12, in next stitch, make one single crochet. Then one decrease. Put the marker in your first stitch and repeat these stitches. In next stitch, make one single crochet, then one decrease. So like this, repeat these stitches till your last stitch. So at the end of round number 12, you will have 12 stitches. So we have 12 stitches. Now at this point, stuff this gap with the filling. Now in round number 13, we are going to make one decrease. So at the end of this round, you will have 6 single crochet stitches. Here we are going, when you decrease, take the front loop, grab and pull through that front loop, then take the next front loop of single crochet, grab the thread and pull through that. So you will have 3 loop. Now grab the thread and pull through first 2, then next 2. So here you have to decrease like this. 1 2. So make total 6 stitches. Round number 13 is done and we have 6 stitches. Now in round number 14 and 15, we are going to make one single crochets in top of each stitch from the previous round. So we have 6 single crochets. So make one single crochet and complete round number 14 and 15. So I have 6 single crochets and completed my round number 15. Now just top of next stitch, just make one slip stitch and pull this thread. Cut with some margin. Now we are going to make the cloves for the garlic. So take white color thread in a needle. Now take this needle from this center and take out at this end. Now take your needle into this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11th row. So top of that 11th row, take your needle and take out at this side on 11th row. Like this. So here count just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11th. So the top of 11th row. Now just pull this thread. Just pull like this. Now take this thread to this center again. This center. Again, take your needle in 11th row of this side. So just pull this thread tight as much as you can. Now take this thread again in the center. Take out to this 11th row of this side and pull tight. So this is done. Now we are going to make this leaves. Make two halves of the thread like this. First we are going to make 8 double chain. So to make the double chain, you have two strands, one this working and one this loose end. So now just roll this loose end in your hook like this. Now grab this thread pull through this first two loop. Again, wrap this loose end in your hook. Grab this thread and pull through that two loops. So like this, you have to make total 8 double chains. After 8 double chain, leave this thread like this, and with working thread make chain 9. After chain 9, make chain 1. So skip first chain and into the next chain make 1 slip stitch, then into the next stitch make 1 slip stitch. Like this, make total 9 slip stitches. So 9 slip stitches. Now again, with this loose end and with this working thread, make 8 double chains. Now just pull this thread. Now take white color thread in a needle. Now put this needle, so this is our leaf. Now take this needle in this center of this leaf. So like this. Now we are going to attach this in the top. So take this needle. Now with this thread, we are going to stitch this leaf. This is done. Now we are going to make this bottom. Now take brown color thread and make strings. So just in 3 finger roll like this. 5 time just cut the thread. Now take this white color thread. Make a knot. Now take this needle and put this in center. So this is done and your garlic is ready. I hope you have learned from this video. If you have any questions or query, please do let me know in comment section. You can also connect to me through my Insta and Facebook page. So see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.